I was asked a question in the comments box on one of my videos. What is the difference between a resection and an intersection? So I thought I'd make a quick video just to go through the difference. I suppose if you break it down to its absolute basics, a resection could be said that it's finding your location on a map. An intersection is finding something else's location on a map. Now, they both involve taking two or more bearings from features you can see and then plotting those bearings onto a map. And where the line crosses, that's the place you're looking for. So here's a quick demonstration of both techniques. Firstly, I'll do the resection. Oh, by the way, I did a Q&A session last week and somebody asked me, why do I always use silver compasses? I don't. So today, to start with, I'm going to be using two compasses. This is a Brunton TruArc 20 Luminous. It's an American compass. And this is a Kamenga 3H, which is also an American compass. Anyway, for a resection, I know that I'm somewhere in this area on a map. I actually don't know where I am, but I'm pretty sure that I'm somewhere around here. That's near enough for now. So what I do is I look around and I find two things that I can see on the ground that I can identify on the map. So let's have a look. Over there is rye loaf, and on the top I can see a trig point. This is a trig point on the top of rye loaf. And in that direction, I can see a wall junction at the bottom of Kirkby Fell. This is the wall junction at the base of Kirkby Fell. So I'll use my Brunton TruArc 20 Luminous to take a bearing to the wall junction, and I get 121 degrees. Next, I'll use my Kamenga 3H to take a bearing from the trig point, and I get 210 degrees. Now, in this area at the moment, the magnetic declination is only 13 minutes west, so that's a tiny fraction of a degree. So I won't be adjusting for magnetic declination, but in your area, you may need to. The next thing I do is I draw those bearings onto my map, and where the lines cross is my location, dead simple. If I need to tell somebody where I am, I can give them my UK grid reference, which is SD869642. You know, that'll tell them my location to within 100 metres. Or if I want to be more precise and tell them where I am to within 10 metres, this would be 8693 6422. Now, obviously, only the UK uses UK grid references, so I can give them my UTM coordinates, or if I was in the military, I could let them know my MGRS, which is Military Grid Reference System. So however you do it, by using a resection, you can let someone else know exactly where you are. So we've done a resection, and now we're going to do an intersection. Don't forget, an intersection is a technique that's used to identify something else's location on a map. And to do that, you need to take a bearing from two known locations. And then all you do is you draw that bearing onto a map, and where the two lines cross, that's where your point of interest is. Now, I know exactly where I am on the map because the Ordnance Survey in the UK, their maps are, how can I put it, they are simply amazing. The amount of detail on an Ordnance Survey map is, it's some of the best in the world. I've not seen anything better. As an example, when I said I know exactly where I am, if you look behind me, can you see this section on the floor here, this shape? Have a look on the map. I'll show you where I am. I'll zoom in, and there you go. This shape is actually on the map. So I've located something in the distance that I've got an interest in. So I'm going to use my Suunto A30, which is made in Finland. Once again, it's not silver. And I'll take a bearing from it from here. So here we go. So I've got a bearing of, try and get it as exact as possible. I've got a bearing of 98 degrees. So 98 degrees from here, from this little square thing. Now, as I said, I don't have lots of other people that I can contact to take another bearing. So I'm going to walk round to the corner of the wall and take another bearing. So I've walked round to the corner of the field and using a Francis Barker M73 compass, which are made in England. So again, not a silver compass. I get a bearing of 221 degrees. I then plot both bearings onto my map. And once again, where the lines cross is the point of interest. And I can then share the UTM coordinates or the grid reference or any other coordinate system with whoever needs to know. So that's the difference between a resection and an intersection. Thanks for watching.